How can fans avoid buying speculative tickets?
Well, I think they should really look out for something called zone seating. That's when a ticket seller doesn't give you a seat, a row, or even a section, but instead says you can buy in this swath. That's what Dave and William bought, and a lot of other folks who ended up not getting their tickets in 2015 got. Some people think it's a deal, but I would be cautious about zone seating.
And it's fascinating how the NFL distributes these tickets, right?
Yeah, so the NFL has confirmed that this year they gave 17.5% to each of the teams that are going to the Super Bowl, the NFC and the AFC champs. Another 5% goes to the home team, which of course is Atlanta. Then 1.2% each goes to the remaining 29 teams. They then get to distribute those however they want. The rest of the tickets comes out of the NFL front office. They then distribute them to sponsors, partners, media partners like ESPN and CBS. And then they also give away 500 tickets. This year, it's primarily going to folks in the military and youth football.
You know, I wonder how the NFL feels about players essentially being able to make a profit off these tickets.
Well, you know, we asked the NFL about that. It says that it has never punished a player, as far as they are aware, for reselling their tickets. We even said, is there any language on the back of a Super Bowl ticket that says resell is prohibited? They say, nope, there is no language like that on the back of the ticket.
All right, so I'm sure a lot of fans out there are wondering, what is the best time to buy Super Bowl tickets and really get the cheapest tickets?
We're kind of getting into the zone. If you're living in Atlanta, you are set because you can sit back and wait. I would wait as long as possible this year because ticket prices are already dropping. They started out lower than they were at this time last year in Minnesota. Yesterday and today were kind of the worst days to buy because it's right after the championship. It's right after people know which teams are going. We found last year, for instance, tickets dropped by more than $2,000 as you got further into this week. The best time to buy is that 24 hours right before the game. There were plenty of tickets that were still available on most secondary sites, and they dropped down to as low about $2,000 a ticket.
Okay, so wait just a little bit longer. Incredible,
if you can.
Incredible reporting. Thank you, Tisha.